I actually like Friends' draft a little bit more. I think it has just a lot more damage. I think they have better laning matchups. Like Darkseer, I think, is going to get a lot. AA might struggle to get some levels.
That's going
to
be a mid tanking, too.
I'm down for Friends.
That's, yeah, I'm all about the mid tanking. I'm with Ben on this one. I think it's tough, though, because Fnatic is such a good team. They're so well coordinated.
I think it's all going to come down to mid one, rather. I really do. I think if he has the kind of game that he had earlier today against the Broodmother, he's going to, Fnatic, have a very good chance, but I do like Friends draft a little better. I'm gonna stay with Fnatic though. I just think they're a better team.
What about
so
you,
with
Fox?
That, yeah,
I'm gonna go with Fnatic as well, just because I saw this Juggernaut sanking matchup earlier today, and it went pretty heavily favored for the Juggernaut, especially just for that mid lane matchup. But I also go with the Hotmas. I think that the drafts are kind of even. I actually kind of like Friends' draft a little more, but I think Fnatic is a team.
Okay.
He's going to take it.
Well, the game is underway, and we're going to throw it right back over to Mott and Fog for the cast.
Thank you, Nahaz. And finally, we are here. Last series of the day. We're going to bring some energy in after. I observed all day today. Lots of Dota to be had, so it was good fun to watch all of the Dota. And we're just going to see a bit more now. Fnatic versus, of course, Friends, the, I guess you could call them underdogs in this situation. They're a team that didn't make TI. No one expected them to go far in this tournament, Fogged. And here they are now against Fnatic, one of the best teams, arguably, in the world. Actually, probably not even arguably. They are one of the best teams in the world.
Yep. We're going to see how well they match up here. Like we were talking about, they have a pretty cool draft. Wombo combo, it's a little bit single core because of the Sven. That's the one reason why I didn't really like it. But they do have tools to deal with it as long as they don't mess up in this early game and the Ricky doesn't cause too much havoc. However, right away we do see Fnatic block. I think that is blocking out the pull with a ward. Or actually just for vision. So they don't really care. They just want to keep an eye on the supports for this other Friends.
We've seen a lot of wards blocking camps earlier today, but they decided to go just for vision. G does grab the bounty rune. 343 tried to click, but not fast enough. So actually, looks like Fnatic mid one will get the top bounty rune. Bottom will, of course, go to G. And what do you think about the resurgence of Sand King? Because over the course of this tournament, and maybe even at the summit, we saw more of this hero, especially in the offlane played by General. But now, obviously, Friends have been playing it. G is now playing it. What do you think about this hero in general?
It's a really strong hero when you're put in a 1v1 position with Caustic versus a melee hero. And I actually thought they were going to put the Jug in the mid lane, but they actually put the Ember, which is not really the best matchup for him. Lots of pressure coming on, always want to fly. Level 1, he takes 3/4 of his health just from right clicks.
Dear God, he does not want to be put in that position. He's holding that point, he doesn't know if he has to use Grave really or Shadow Wave, maybe even Poison Touch, but he'll scope the Shadow Wave, heal himself up. 3-4-3 will be scouted by Sentry, he'll take it down himself, so trying to get as much vision out of there as possible. Their Sentry goes down, but I don't think they really care about that. They just want to make sure that 3-4-3 is having a good time down bottom.
Yeah, there's no other Sentry. This should be a really good lane for a G, though, like I was mentioning. It's very good versus Ember Spirit. You can pop the Flame Guard instantly with either one of your abilities.
He already has 5 last hits, 2 denies. The Ember Spirit having only 1 CS, he'll get some work done under the tower, which will help get him both experience as well as last hits, and we'll go from there. And again, mid one, again, if you guys didn't see the Manila Major group stages, mid one struggled heavily playing this hero, at least in the safe lane. So it's going to be interesting to see how he does later on down the road with this hero in this particular game. Always want to fly again, still super low. I'm pretty sure that was him doing all of that work, but he's going to have to back up still as a Shadow Wave, and him in Ohio will go toe-to-toe with the help of Aloha Dance on the side of Friends.
Yep, mid lane, it's just going to be pretty much straight farm, but like I was saying, G should be able to pull out quite ahead here until the Ricky does make his movement with smokescreen. Once the Ricky makes movements, if it's not identified, they actually do have quite good kill potential on the Sand King with the smokescreen.
So what's the timing then for the Sand King, or for Friends in general? Maybe a blink dagger, or he gets another item early, maybe like boots, Aether Lens, or something like that. What do you go? When do you go with that Sand King?
Oh, with the Sand King, just whenever they really feel like the Sven, like they have to just depends on like how the lanes are still going to go. It's a little early to tell if the Sven's going to go for the Dominator build and everything, or if he's going to have to just be this like hero that actually has to join the fights a lot sooner.
Likewise, will that Tide react once he gets level 6s? Oh, look at that Stomp doing damage. Caustic Finale might be able to bring him down. He's going to use the Fairy Fire, not enough damage yet. Great Searing Change, he's going to salve up as well. They're trying to chase him down. And there's the Burrow Strike, and that should do the job. And it is going to be first blood going the way of Friends and G. But they do get the return kill as they get 3-4-3 in with the Blink Strike, and they take down the Elder Titan at least. So they will get rebuttal at the end of the day, Fogged.
Yep, the Elder Titan actually makes the first move instead of the Ricky, so good awareness there by Friends to make that first move.
I thought 3-4-3 was bottom. was up that mid lane very quickly. I mean, he's been all over the map, and I think as a Ricky player, you kind of have to be. You have to be moving around. You have to be making plays and doing the best that you can. There is going to be a Blade Fury. Yoku's going to get caught out. They have the Ice Vortex as well as Cold Feet, but
body blocks,
and they will be able to get the latch hopefully here, and it should be. No, it actually gets off just in time. I was surprised. I thought he was going to have enough there to be able to actually get a Cold Feet coming through from DJ, but even with those body blocks and the Ice Vortex, the Cold Feet doesn't latch.
Yeah, ends up living because of his fairy fire, so nice, very nice play there by Yoku.
Coiling Blade for the Sand King. And, oh god, mid one is, I feel like he's so poor.
Yeah, he's gonna get, like I was saying, very heavily pressured in this lane. It's very easy for the Sand King to just play when it's just him there. Do we see a stomp coming out on the Ember Spirit? Yeah.
And his Flame Guard's gone too, like you talked about. One Burrow Strike and maybe a little bit of caustic finale damage, which I believe is magical, and that should be enough to take it off. And he's gonna have at least the bottle coming out now, so he'll be able to stay in lane a bit better. But look at the CS, it's 22 and 5 for G, and then on the other side, 11 and 1 for mid one, and he's just not having a great time in this mid lane.
That's kind of why I was saying I thought they would put the Jug mid rather than the Ember in the mid lane, because Ember, at least versus the Darkseer, okay, sure, you're not really that happy having the tank eye and shields and everything, but at least you have a stun and a lockdown to proc that Cold Feet, so you actually can have like kill potential and like threatening like prowess on the Darkseer. But when you lane like this, you're just kind of like losing two lanes for no reason when you could be coming out much more even.
And Fnatic, they did have a rotation spotted out by A, the Observer Ward, and B, of course, there's going to be a Reek there who also gets stomped, although I don't think he really cares. He's, of course, no vision on him at this point. Just doing some damage to him and want some harass at this point. But yeah, you're absolutely right. And you also could just Blade Fury out the wave if you really need to as the Jug. Just sit back, Blade Fury, and contest the runes. Maybe rotate if you want to. But Mushi is going to be playing in the safe lane, and he's doing okay in farm. 18 last hits, obviously a little bit behind the rest of the opposing safe laner in Aloha Dance. But then, of course, 34 last hits for Ohio for Fnatic, who is more than likely jungling at this point, I believe. Gank mid potentially, and as well as top lane Fury, Cold Feet. It's enough to be there. Ice Vortex, not enough. They have the Blink Strike, it's not enough damage. He again does survive. And 4 stick charges as well.
See, but even there, like, I think about it, and I'm like, if that was an Ember instead of Jug there, right, they would have the Searing Chains at least to grab and hold him down under the smoke screen rather than this situation that's happening. And the Jug is actually struggling quite a bit in that in the CS department versus the Darkseer.
Ohio is having a great time. Level 6, he's got Ravage up ready to go. Again, we talked about his CS. He's on top right now. He's got his Arcane's 500 gold as well. A Quelling Blade not even turning into Iron Talon.
We talked about that during the draft. We can see the Epicenter actually coming out from mid one.
Searing Chains cancels it. G won't be able to get off his ultimate. And of course, the stomp wasn't there from Nofear. And with the dust off coming through, is Nofear going to chase down the Flame Guard too much? Burst Strike coming in. Mid one will take some damage. Here comes the Iron Shell trying to turn this around. Can they get either kill? Yoku's coming in. Searing Chains again from mid one. The stomp about to hit, and it will. Is there enough damage? Burst Strike is ready in 1 second. They'll find the pick off. And this time they will pick up the Ember Spirit, although it did take a lot of effort and a couple of rotations. They're able to get it done with G getting the kill.
Nice movements though by Friends, completely outnumbering Fnatic there. Almost, Minduan almost getting a kill there, like almost getting 2 kills even, but nice little extra rotation coming out from the Darkseer. And yeah, like you were mentioning, the Tidehunter refarming in the offlane. We mentioned this in the draft, it's a Spend Dazzle. The other Titan prioritized just kind of walking around, and Ricky even gave him a good head start in that lane too, so no surprise to see Ohio dominating the CS boards there. But it is I don't know if that's the reason that it's crippling the other lanes, but I think the lane setup is more so.
We'll wait and see how this end of the laning phase shapes up. Ohio, again, he has Ravage. Arcane's right now in Ring of Regen as well, interestingly enough. Might be heading for the headdress, then into that mech later on down the road. Would not be surprised. This G, of course, is just going to jungle real quick. He's a bit low in health. And for now, it looks like Friends, they have the edge in terms of both, I guess, your safe lane farmer as well as your mid lane farmer especially. And mid one is, again, just, we can't stress it enough, he's being shut down. But what's the potential to come back for this Ember Spirit as we move through the, you know, the 7 to 10 minute mark here?
He's okay. They just have to be getting a lot more information with the Ricky, just watching the other Titans' movements at all times, because the only way he really dies is if he gets stomped like with a Sand King, Burrow, and Epicenter.
343's job essentially is then to be that mobile ward.
Yeah.
Is what you're telling me?
Pretty much.
Well, at least he got a kill earlier. He's doing a pretty good job, but he's rotated
DJ.
Top, and DJ, I think, is donezo. Yeah, that's one more. Did he even have Iron Shell on him? He didn't.
Yeah.
I don't think the Darkseer did. He punched him.
The Sand King had it, yeah. So you can barely see it on a lot of heroes lately. I've been noticing that.
It's a little difficult, but well, G is He's gonna sit in the tree line, 1100 gold in the bank, so maybe heading towards that blink dagger. He has arcanes. If he wants to get Aether Lens, which he probably will later, he certainly can. He's cutting a path through the tree line to look for that burrow strike. You have the TP coming in, DJ not scouted. I don't think there's a ward behind the tower here for friends, but they should see him now. Mushi and DJ sitting at the tower currently. Meanwhile, everywhere else, not much else happening. Bottom lane, it's just more free farming for Aloha Dance. Now up to 44, but again, Ohio continues to dominate that CS chart.
Yep, still not too bad though. This is the opening that mid one needs to catch back up. Sand King being off the map, he knows he can farm the mid lane fine versus another Titan. So a little bit of a catch up point here. And G's still trying to make these aggressive moves, even towards the bottom now. So more spin for mid one.
Did he get the infant center off? Not again. The Ravage cancels it, and G just wasn't expecting the Ravage to come out that quickly. 3-4-3 still alive, but barely. Always want to fly. Healing himself up after the grave came through. There's another burst strike coming in. Aloha Dance is farming, realizing that I don't think they can get the kill. Gush onto all. Always want to fly. It looks like Aloha Dance will turn his attention to Ohio. And finally, they turn around and they get the kill. He was waiting for a Stormhammer, but now the Blade Fury. Mushi's TP'd in, and Aloha Dance about to fall. Looking for a second as well. G has the burrow strike, and he gets out and gets the kill in time.
Nice burrow by G.
I think scrappy was the term we were using about this game, and it certainly has that feel for him.
Top lane, DJ now getting dove up, but he should be just fine with the cold feed under the tower. Doesn't freeze up Yoku, but still pushes him off. Nice rotation there coming up from G. Makes the movement. He sits top waiting. He doesn't see the opportunity, ports bottom, and just ends up like turning that fight around. Even though he didn't get the epicenter off, it was a nice little extended duration of fight. But mid one, like we were mentioning, that gives him a bit of space. He kills the other Titan mid and brings his net worth up a bit.
I mean, that's huge for mid one to get back into the game. You can see where his net worth is right now, actually just below the Tidehunters here, which is really important. Still not on par with G, who again has having a great time. He's 1800 gold right now. He talked about it, the epicenter didn't get off, but the burrow strike is like a lot of the reason you pick this hero to begin with. I mean, it's just a great disable. Obviously with Aghanim Scepter and Aether Lens, the range is ridiculous.
Yep.
So G is already having a great time. And if he can get to that blink dagger, pretty soon he'll be doing just as well. However, he's gonna get
the devil
smoke screened up. There's gonna be a steering chance, remnant forward, and he's gonna fall.
They get the kill. As soon as you say it.
Literally like a half a second after I talked about it, he walks up and dies. Sick. All right, cool.
That is the threat of the Ricky being sitting on your runes. So nice little play there by 343 in mid one.
He is level 5 on the Ricky too. Experience wise, I don't think it's that bad for him. And I guess the rest of the support is coming out. So
the really costly thing now for Fnatic is at least Mushi. He's sitting on 2,800 net worth. His first rotation into that bottom lane nets himself one kill, but then dies right afterwards. And like we were mentioning, he was getting pressured quite heavily from this Darkseer so far in the lane.
That's the problem. Darkseer against a melee carry in lane is really rough, and he wasn't getting as much CS as he would like. So Mushi having a rough start. He can come back. We'll see if he decides to go for Battle Fury. If so, double Battle Fury would be the case, because then mid one, obviously, that's going to be more than likely his item. What do you think about itemization for that Juggernaut?
I think Jug shouldn't. I don't think he should go for the Battle Fury this game. They should just let the Ember farm up the stacks for now. Just get his bots. I think Jug can probably just go the items that we've been seeing more often lately.
Yasha,
just the phase, Yasha, Manta, Diffusal.
Yeah. So we'll wait and see what Mushi decides to build. Doesn't even have a heal yet, so we don't have to worry about that too much. It's going to be wild. God's Strength, there's the Stormhammer, Ohio. He does have the Raven Drop, but I don't think it'll save him. Of course, a lot of his damage is physical anyways, so if used Raindrop, only stopping the Stormhammer damage, then him going down to the God's Strength, this Aloha Dance just finds him out of position. So that's twice now that the God's Strength has done a real good job of bringing Ohio down.
There's like, those are really costly deaths. He's like the highest net worth team, net worth person on the side of Dire. So when he gives up kills like that, it's like extremely costly. They had Ravage up as well, and they just have everybody else farming. I feel like he could have been in a more defensive positioning.
So Ohio will go down. He's up in 11 seconds right now, though. More farming, no real pushing just yet. Sitting behind enemy lines is going to be, I think that's the AA, just trying to leech experience and get to 6. In fact, he is. He's got the Ice Blast ready. They're sitting and situated right now with always want to fly, walking in. That's a bit sketchy, I think, if you're the Ancient Apparition. And hopefully he should be fine for the time being, but Fnatic may be looking to set up a defense at this bottom lane, not that they're pushing at this point.
Dominator Echo Saber coming online soon for Sven, getting his stacks up. G also, pretty sure he picked up the Blink Dagger in this, so looking very good for friends right now at this moment in time. This is their like best timing window when they have these items.
Top 2 in net worth. Mid 1 has caught back up significantly. We were really concerned about how he was doing. That smoke might have been caught out by that Observer Ward. In fact, it was more than likely seen by the Dire side. Fnatic shouldn't be caught by this, however. They'll sit down bottom. 3-4-3 would be first contact, potentially Ohio, with Ravage ready to go. No mech just yet, though. And no Fear and G, as well as Always Wanna Fly, trying to determine where they want to go. They want to go mid, they want to go bottom. They scan, Dire Scan actually coming out to see if they're in that mid lane. Instead, it'll be a TP top from Aloha Dance. And for now, it looks like that smoke's not really going to accomplish anything.
Yeah, this is just a missed opportunity, but it's very good for Fnatic. They get a lot of space in the bottom. They're going to be able to pressure the tower. However, Mushi now top lane does actually... Okay, he spins and TP's mid, it looks like, from to get away from the top lane.
Oh, but then he just gets TP centered on the Frozen Strike coming in. No more Blade Fury. Like you said, he spinned to TP. He could have just gone home. Instead, he dies, and G finally is like, there's the epicenter. That's it. You're not going to cancel it this time.
Yeah, I want to say he spawned and like tanked the wave top with an Ion Shell, and then he TP'd to the mid lane, and G was already in position there. So nice awareness there from Friends to find Mushi.
That was, I think, the Blink Dagger reveal. Ice Blast sailing through and might cancel. It like it will. Ravage coming out. Aloha Dance is low. Not dead. Finally, mid one will bring him down. Now, DJ going toe-to-toe with Yoku with the Ion Shell on top. There's the Spirit stomping onto 2-3-4-3. Smoke screen is up. Yoku still trying to chase it down. Here comes G, that blink dagger. Burrow Strike misses. He missed time the blink. It was about to come off cooldown. He didn't use it in time. Anchor Smash is coming through. G still getting hit up. See the illusion coming out. Earth Splitter, looks like it's not connected. G jumps back in, getting mid one, but back in the main fight. Yoku still trying to bring Ohio 3-4-3 down. There's the remnant away. It looks like mid one will survive for the time being, but Yoku tries to get off the path of retreat as he TPs out. He has a remnant in the tree lines. He wants to regen quick and get back into this fight because it seems to be never ending. Gosh, there's the smoke screen. The stop will come through. Great tricks of the trade, Yoku. There's going to be the anchor smash. He's at 30 HP and will stay alive. Now G comes in, gets the kill on that Riki, but will pay with his life as they do find him with the dust. That was, I don't know what happened in that fight. That honestly, like, what?
You summed it up pretty well, honestly.
What just happened?
That fight lasted an insane amount of time. I'm pretty sure Sven was farming the whole time, though, so that's definitely in favor of Friends. And it's on the Fnatic side of the map.
He was up there, actually, and he died.
He died, that's right.
Then he went back to farm.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He died and went back. And I think he farmed multiple, like, 2 or 3 waves, and he was pressuring the tower after he died, so.
Well, at least he's got that going for him. Mid one and Mushi, a double carry combo. Aloha Dance, Blade Fury's up. He's looking for them right click. He's going to use the Stormhammer onto mid one, but, well, the mech is up there with Ohio coming through. Stomp from No Fear, and they might get away another kill. The Shadow Wave will come out, and looks like they'll stay asleep for the time being. Although Aloha Dance does go down, he does pick up that Echo Saber.
Cast the curse. I'm like, oh, he's getting some nice free farm bottom after that fight's happening after he dies, and then he just dies back to back. So that is not good for this man. This is also another benefit for Fnatic here. Catching up here in the back. A Ice Blast on top.
And the center for G. Well, doing some nice work, but not enough. The Grave comes out. No Fear still alive. They're going to have to wall up again, and Ohio will walk through. So tanky. Omni Slash will come in. They will finally break down that Dazzle. Aloha Dance is still dead there. We will at least get the trade off by bringing down the Tidehunter. No Fear. He's sitting on 150 HP, and mid one is going to remnant right on top and find an easy pickup there. So 3 down on the side of Friends, and it looks like Fnatic are starting to turn it around there with the help of mid one and Mushi coming in with some nice damage. And they're not done yet. It looks like G's about to get chased down. Mid one, does he have a remnant left? It looks like he has one, but he's not going to use it for the time being. He's just going to back up and go farm mid or top.
Scrappy fights, like we were mentioning, though, all over the place. Yeah, it's a very close game though so far, and they both have their mechs now coming out, so the team fight potential from both sides is pretty even. It just depends on the cooldowns. If the cooldowns are there, it probably goes a little bit favoring to the sides of Friends, even though that they have the Ravage.
I did want to ask you about Aloha Dance and the helm over the armlet, which is what we see commonly. Obviously, with the helm of the Dominator, you have a lot of gold to be taken at some point in time. Of course, there is a ward to block that camp now, but what do you think about the helm in this situation?
I mean, I personally like helm into Echo Saber pretty much every single time over the armlet. You accelerate your farm so much more heavier, and buying armlet and Echo Saber feels very weird. It feels like it's just like redundant at one point. And I feel like without Echo Saber, the hero doesn't really, he's not even really like spend. He doesn't have his actual power.
Yeah, I mean, Echo Saber obviously one of the better. It's best on him or one of the best heroes behind. Always want to fly and off the smoke screen. Will live, might get his Grave off the top, but no such luck. G is going to get sounds of both best smoke screen. Ice Blast, Steering Chains, Remnant, and Tricks the Trade. See you later. They will get off the Ravage on top of Yoku as well. Looks like it might be three deaths to mix up though, and here comes the Mohai Dance. They're gonna try to turn this Ohio to Heat Tank. He'll make up as well. He'll back away with mid one. Out of hand right now. Stormhammer gets the kill. Sleight of Fist. Only clearing out some of the creep waves. Here's gonna be mid one with Remnant back through. He needs to get home and try to get some mana back, and they will find again the AA. Ohio Dance has found himself a double kill. Might find a triple. The smoke screen down. Not enough to bring him down. Mushi on these slides will go. Yoku's still pretty tanky. No more back still. Seren chases up. 343 jumps back in. Surge away. Can Yoku stay alive? The Blade Fury, the last right click, the Shadow Wave is up, and Mushi will not be able to find him. Long-range Stormhammer. Mushi's about to fall. Vacuum back. Double kill for Yoku. Four dead for Fnatic in what looked to be a pretty solid fight for them. And all of a sudden, it just turned so sour for Fogged.
Yeah, fight just lasted way too long. They've blown all their spells, all their ultimates already on the side of Fnatic. They got the Sanken kill, which was really high priority and everything, but the Sven just way too tanky, just kind of running around, just beating the crap out of everybody with the sustain from Dazzle and the Weave on top.
It just felt like the Sven kind of came out of nowhere in that engagement. He took a couple of seconds to get there, but when he did, he had his God strength, and he is top of the net worth. Looking at the Sven right now, itemization.
It was looking.
What he's gonna go for next on the Sven.
It was looking pretty good for Fnatic at first, but yeah, just letting that fight drag on a little bit too long and just kited around that tier one.
Well, there's a BKB coming out. What I imagine would be a BKB for the Sven as he has a full hammer. I would be shocked to see anything else at this point, but stranger things have happened. And meanwhile, there's a battle fury, and of course, Nahas talked about that armor. Cleave doesn't really care about that armor, so the battle fury is very important for mid one, obviously, and that'll accelerate his farm always after having boots of travel as well. Now, it is only 3,000 lead. It'll get bigger with this agent stack, but do you think Fnatic should be worried right now, or do you think they have an okay game plan then heading into the late game?
I think they should feel a little worried, but they have to just, you know, stick to their game plan. As long as they have eyes on the Sand King in any ways, basically, this Ember Spirit can freely split push. He should not die to anything else. Like, if he dies to the Sven, it's only because, like, it's a Blink Dagger surprise in some situation like that. So he should be pretty free to do that. G now, actually.
Uh-oh. That is not good. TP is gonna come through. I think Splash will hit in time. It will not, and it would have been off the mark more than likely anyways. And so he's gonna continue on to building his Aghanim Scepter now with only one component away. It's a good effort. Mushi not having quite the damage yet. He'll have his Diffusal Blade pretty soon here, though, and that's at least a good sign.
Yeah, Mushi being that underfarmed is what's really, like, scary for Fnatic here. 3x3. Getting stomped up. He actually does not trick the trade to dodge it.
He does have it still, and he has the smoke screen. They're waiting to fight around it. They have protection, I'm sure.
He's dusted right now, but he might be able to just die instantly. Just
kidding. That Shadow Wave, actually. Yeah, I was waiting for it to take a little bit longer, him to juke with Blink Strike.
Yeah, Blink Strike to the chain. Happy's actually.
Blinks 4, DJ just completely avoids it. G, he's had a couple of hit or miss epicenters so far. He's had one good one, I think, earlier down bottom, and then a couple other ones were like, eh. And that one in particular was...
Yeah, he's had good stuns though, so whatever.
Still, he's been doing a good job for his team. Of course, coming out of the laning phase, he was the, I think, really the reason why they were doing as well as they were at the beginning of the game.
He did his job. Like, he looks at the draft at the heavy. He's like, okay, well, I'm, you know, the space maker. We have a single core Sven in essence, so we have to just accelerate and enhance him as much as possible. So I have to sack myself a bit as the Sand King in this game and kind of just make the moves, even if it's not the most optimal and efficient play for myself.
Right now, top of the net worth, Sven. He likes to be in that 2-3k net worth lead. Unfortunately, mid one is right on his tail.
He's got his BKB though, and that, like, pretty much counters everything from the side of Fnatic for now.
Well, there is a blank with the time launcher. He may not be able to get it off in time. That's the thing. Ice Blast is gonna sail through, no fear. Blade Fury. That's just to the right. He'll actually stay alive. There's gonna be this, but the grave gets off. And the mech as well, Shadow Wave. They have to use it a lot to kill him, but they will end up bringing him down still. A lot used, but they end up getting the kill. Dyer's top and
forced a lot of reaction, at least.
Wow, that ward is pretty sick. It's 3-4-3. That's the benefit of being a Ricky. Yes, if they have detection, you die, like you said, almost instantly. But the ability to get some solid wards down, like behind the tower, like the one in between the tier 1 and the tier 2 tower mid is great, that one there. It's just there's so many well-placed wards coming out that give so much vision for Fnatic.
Yeah, that's one of the big strengths from Ricky that maybe I guess some people overlook, but being able to place wards when and not breaking your invis is pretty enormous. You can get so much information on the map.
But, well, he...
Right there, he catches that ward too, just because he's invis walking around.
Hopefully he sees it and he can grab a sentry ward.
Yeah, Mushi pinged it, so hopefully they were aware of why he was pinging. This is, yep, like we saw, BKB picked up for Sven. This is one of their timings to go. I think that the ward may have caught in a glimpse of the smoke.
I thought they all did it in the tree line, but I could be wrong. I mean, I'd be shocked if that's the case.
All weaved up, though, walking up a hill.
Yeah, they have a lot of armor right now with Warcry. They will see 3-4-3 in the dust will go. They have, of course, the Ravage coming out, playing into the shit. It's just Ice Blast coming through. They'll take one. Now, no fear in trouble as well. Cobalt Speedy does give the stomp off, but he ends up dying. But here comes the Aloha Dance. Like you said, BKB top ready to go. Vacuum up into the epic center.
Combo.
Look at that cleave, bringing down three. Like you said, Wombo combo indeed. Still good Omni Slash. Play the Fizz as well. Yoku's low. No mech ready to go. He misses the last right click, and Mushi has to leave. But the Burrow Strike will catch him and gets the Aloha Dance. A double kill. Yoku.
Mid one missed the slide as well. Like just off the mark on Yoku.
Where is Yoku? Where is that guy? He TP'd out. He made it away in time. Oh, that fight was looking so good for Fnatic, and what a combination of abilities coming out from friends, showing you why they are this far into the tournament at Star Ladder Season 2.
That's why we were mentioning, you know, we did like friends' draft. It has an insane amount of Wombo combo, and right there, they showcased it.
And it's only going to get better as G has picked up not only an Aghanim Scepter, but an Aether Lens as well. So the range for that Burrow Strike is pretty much the entire screen. If you look at the Sand King, it's pretty much your entire screen. So Sleight of Fist coming out mid from mid one, looking for some potential action, I think, on the Dazzle. And it looks like he will end up bringing him down. Old Grave is there. Meanwhile, bottom, there's the stomp up onto Ohio. And it looks like Ohio, yeah, mid one does end up finding that kill on the Dazzle in the mid lane. But Ohio and No Fear, we're going... Of course, toe-to-toe down bottom, Ohio trying to get that kill, but you can't really solo as a time hunter, unfortunately.
Yeah, Fnatic just needs to, honestly, split up and just farm as much as possible in this game. Even though they have like the Ravage and the AA Blast and everything, they need Mushi to get much more farm.
Yeah, I mean,
8k net worth is just not cutting it at this point.
It could be worse for Mushi, but 8k, it just feels like his impact is... He's having a couple of good Omni Slashes, but it's just not enough yet. Again, a lot of that damage, obviously physical. And you have so much Warcry Weave, obviously making it very difficult for you to kill friends.
It's hard for them to land like big Ravages and AA Blasts on multiple heroes. Like they're that in that situation, that fight, they took out both supports instantly, but they didn't really hit any of the core heroes. They were all like split up throughout the fight. So G now actually getting grabbed up. He might put down here.
He just bought his items, tricks the trade, Remnant back in coming through from mid one. Another Remnant just secure the kill. There's going to be the Earth Splitter, but it's not nearly enough to kill through 4-3. And No Fear might be the second in this kill line. Shadow Weave will come through. They have the Dazzle nearby.
Oh, nice
great
dodge.
Blink. Great blink to get away from that Stormhammer. Aloha Dance not able to actually find a successful stun and kill. Still, they will have the Astral chasing Ohio down. A stomp could come through, and they could set something up here.
This is perfect, though. This is, like I was mentioning, Fnatic doesn't want to take like straight-up engagements. They want to get these little scrappy fights, get like a kill or two, force reaction, and then just keep splitting up and farming because they need to get the farm up on these two heroes. But
he just moves top and he finds the Juggernaut. Oh man, it was the tail end of that God Strength and he must have found a stun with no blade. I think he must have Blade Fury the wave. I think that's the only way, really.
I guess he must have just gotten, he Blade Fury, I think maybe after the stun, and then he just got like the Echo Saber mini slow and just beat down by the Sven, like you mentioned, the tail end of that God Strength. But still, that's a huge mistake for Mushi there. His team was making up the space for him to farm and he unfortunately gets picked off trying to get that tier one.
So Aloha Dance to say, I'll make a free push, but here's the Ravage on the Yoku as well as No Fear, the Ice Blast, and yes, and that's not on the mark as the Force Staff comes through from Yoku, who's able to get out and looks like, well, Ohio says that's it, I'm gonna have to TP away, and DJ does the same except for the fact that DG is here. The stomp comes through, Shadow Wave will blow him up, the caustic finale exploding to top it all off, to end, of course, his life.
G's like, oh, you're 3,000 range within my tower? You're not getting out.
You literally have vision anywhere, and it's just like, well, I guess
Aloha, I'm going for these solo kills all over the place. Ohio?
Yeah, he should find this. One more right click. He's so close that he gets out in time. Uh-oh. Now that TP coming through, this is dangerous. If anyone to stop this full 10-second BKB duration, I believe, might have been 9. And he's able to, 9-second BKB duration, and he's able to escape with it on. I thought it was going to be off as right at the tail end of that TP scroll.
Did I see that properly? Can we get a click on that Ember Spirit again? Because he actually had an Oblivion staff.
He does have an Oblivion staff.
So I guess he's going to be going for an Orchid on himself.
Yeah. We saw that from, might have been from Fnatic as well earlier on in the tournament. It was from someone. I can't remember what team did it though. But there definitely was another
on Ember Spirit,
okay. Orchid Malevolence. I'm almost positive.
I must have not seen that one, unfortunately. Damn it.
So what's the Orchid for in this situation, Fogged?
Dazzle. You don't have to focus him as hard. There's no way he can get his spells up if you just Orchid him in the back line. Same thing with the Elder Titan.
I feel like Dazzle will be the target more so than anyone else. Although no fear can be disruptive, Dazzle with Grave is nothing short of annoying.
Yeah, it also can help him get like his own solo kills and stuff like that, and like have his own potential. But now again, Aloha going for these solo plays.
He is a man. He goes in and he knows when he wants to get a kill. Unfortunately, he will be cold defeated. The ice flash comes in there. Could be obvious flash. He's got the BKB and the God Strength, but he's low. And Mushi will end up bringing him down with Ricky getting the last hit with the Trick of it right now. No fear in trouble. Double Remnant coming in. And the Blade Fury Speed with the Silence on top. They've lost two for Friends, and that's the biggest kill you could have gotten in this game for Fnatic. And look how much gold they get from it. 600 for Ricky, who got the last hit on that spec.
Whoa. Dragon Lance Ricky.
Oh my god, what?
I was wondering why he did so much damage there, but yeah, he's got a lot of agility now because of that. So, don't think I've seen that one before.
I guess it's cheap stats. That's all I could say about it. He's been scouted, by the way, from that Sentry Ward, but he will drop down the Observer.
But yeah, Fnatic gets a huge opportunity there. Aloha Pants. Aloha Dance playing. Aloha Pants. Nice. Good job, man. Aloha Dance playing just a little bit too aggressive. Playing on his own just a bit too much. Should be playing more around his team, especially with the lineup that they have.
I think you've made a new name for a moment.
Aloha Pants? I don't know. That was...
Aloha Pants?
I don't even know. I have no words for why I said that.
Well, either way, we're going to run with it. Still, they'll take Roshan for Fnatic right now. You can see the net worth chart on the left side of your screen. And Ember Spirit is still at the top, but right next to, and right beside him, right below him, I should say, obviously is going to be that Sven. And then, of course, the next two are Friends Heroes. So if we look at the net worth graph, it should show a sizable, maybe not sizable lead. Friends is only down to about 1,000 net worth advantage at this point, and experience is 100% even. So. Fnatic have done a great job evening the series up, and a lot of that I think has to do with mid 1 and 3-4-3 and just good team play in general.
They just have to watch their positioning always on the side of Fnatic. That's the scary thing about playing versus like Sven, Darkseer, and just like Wombo Combo type things like this. So they always will, Friends will always have that in their back pocket.
Ohio, that was awkward. Aggressively avoids the Stormhammer with the Remnant.
Oh my god.
He's like halfway across the map now, so he is no boss for 30.
That says something though about the player. When Ohio is the Tidehunter and he gets revealed, he blinks backwards and mid one blinks in. Mushi though getting jumped up.
Yeah, he's in trouble. He does have that Blink Fury. No way, he's just obviously still in trouble. They can't find the kill though. Aloha Dance, he just gets credit too much in 4-3. Might be a bit of target back here, but no wall coming out now. There's some slight of his steering chance as well. Jump in, there's going to be the empty center. Might be enough. Stormhammer onto 2 mid, 1 in trouble, but that's just the agent. That's all that it is for now.
God Strength and BKB are gone.
He still has Ravage ready to go, but he can't get Blink off. The Stomp comes through. 3-4-3 trying to chase all by his lonesome, and as a Ricky, that's a little bit tough. 4-4, Blink Ravage, nicely done. Catches just about everyone except Yosu. Wall drop down, Omni Slash will take down, no fear, but that's it for the time being. Jump back in for mid one, looking for more, always want to fly. Grave done, mid one. There's the Orchid onto G. He's not getting away. They've got Searing Chains, they've got the Anchor Smash, they've got the kill. Monster kills free for mid one. And he is doing so much work this game after a rough start.
Yeah, and this is where Friends Fnatic starts getting their strength back. Friends just not being able to find the targets and burst them down instantly, not able to get that Wombo combo off. The God Strength and the BKB are completely wasted on the Sven in that fight, which is very unfortunate for him, but...
He's not done.
He's not done yet. Going for Yoku as well.
He went for the chains already. He didn't. Now he goes for it. And here comes the Crypt Defend, two hit, three. That's all it takes, and he is dead for 75 seconds. No buyback. That is a long time to be dead for an Ember Spirit. But good news for Fnatic fans, they are taking over the enemy Aegis deck. And by taking over, I mean they're literally just taking it.
I do want to give one credit though to that people may not have noticed in that fight. DJ actually with his urn did a really good job. He kept throwing the urn on the Sand King, so G was actually having a really hard time finding blink positionings. Just saw that in the back ends of the fight.
Ooh, good vacuum on Ohio. Okay. Down to the low ground too. He's out of mana, force, out of Nora's blink for 3 seconds. This is going to be tough to get out of if you're Ohio, and with the Astral following you, the Axel as well, I think you might just go down into this Aloha Dance spin with all of those years in the vicinity. Some good effort there from Friends. They have 31 seconds without mid one in the Ember Spirit, and then 55 without that Tidehunter.
Definitely one of the closer games we've seen in this tournament, though. Very back and forth, and both lineups match each other quite evenly.
It's getting tense. What did you, has G picked anything up since he got his magnetic ones?
Boots travel.
Wow. He really wants to be involved in pretty much every fight, and I don't blame him. Like, that's, I feel like that's his job. Just like, make sure you're involved in fights, make sure you're getting kills and setting up kills with Burrow Strike and Epicenter.
Always good to be able to like, just push out lanes freely too and just join fights.
Speaking of which, mid one will do the same as he's gonna head up top right now, and he's just respawned, so hopefully he can stay alive a little bit longer. The Jug does pick up a Blink Dagger as well, so lots of mobility items. Mid one has remnanted back to, of course, the base. They will just barely miss him as they start farming top lane for Friends. So, all right, looking at the way this game has progressed right now, Fogs, 32 minutes into the game, the net worth is very even at this point, although a bit in favor of Friends right now. Who do you favor and where do we go from here?
It's super up to just like what happens in these engagements, honestly. It's like if the Wombo comes out for Polarity, or for, why do I say Polarity? I just saw the name, whatever. When for Friends and they hit like multiple Pura with it can really screw Fnatic, but if Fnatic doesn't get hit by that Wombo combo, then they can easily win these fights. So it's very even, honestly. Like this game is extremely close. But I think Fnatic wants to prolong the game just a bit longer because their heroes inevitably do scale better. They just have to worry about that heavy, obviously, vacuum.
Available blink, Ravage gets off onto three. Nicely done. Omniclash onto the low end as well, but nobody did it just yet. Three for three's low. He gets the trick to the trade off, though, and he also gets back up as well. Now, we'll lift your way. Mushi in some trouble. There's the Orca done to G. They get the steering hits off from the low end into the BKB. Looks like it's done. He's gonna get remnanted on. He will have the grave to come through Shadow Wave, and they might just disengage here. Nobody dying just yet, although Aloha Dance has gone back in. No BKB, DJ's earning up. He's gonna hide behind the tree, and he gets forced away, but that's... that was a good try, DJ, but that was not going to work in that situation, I don't believe.
Still lacking a little bit of damage, though.
Lushi? Oh, good fingers. Went down in time with that newly minted dagger, and all right, two dead, but they're only supports for Fnatic, so that's that.
Yeah, I mean, they should just keep splitting up and looking for better opportunities, though. I don't think I still think they don't really want to take a 5v5 engagement, just unless someone's like completely out of position, sure, but straight up 5v5, they're still not on the ideal setup for themselves. They want to have a bit more farm on that Juggernaut, so they have those two very strong carry heroes.
Look at the Darksteer's item, Pipe of Insight, as well as an Ultimate Orb for perhaps either a Linked Sphere or Hex, one of those few items. I think Hex against the Ember Spirit is always a good item to go for, as he's so slippery to deal with and difficult.
On the Darksteer, you were saying, right?
Yes.
Yeah. I like Hex.
It looks like it's going to be one of those two Linked Sphere Hex, so we're going to find out.
Very weird, he's not going for the Blink Dagger that we usually do see, with especially with the Dark, especially with Sven and everything, like the Wombo combo like we've been mentioning over and over.
He has the Force to have him be thinking that's enough. I mean, you'd like to have that instant movement, but sometimes it's just not there. God Strength,
oh, double crit!
He gets two, and he might get a third here. He does get forced back towards the tower, and somehow Aloha Dance with that ridiculous amount of damage doesn't get the kill.
He got the double Echo Saber crit. That was 1,300 back-to-back crits.
That looked like Ohio was in panic mode, and he was luckily able to make it away with it. Of course, his Force Staff as well as the teammate's Force Staff allowed him to survive in that situation, but Force Split pushing as they take down the Tier 2 tower down bottom lane. Roche probably is, I would say, the next point of contention. I don't know what you think, Yannis, but...
Yeah, more than likely. I mean, mid one's just doing the job that he's supposed to be doing, just split push. Like I mentioned in the draft, he doesn't really have, he's not really too susceptible of dying as long as he sees like the, now it's like the Sand King and the Sven, as long as he sees both of them on the map. And he actually goes for a Bloodthorn over the Daedalus. I was gonna ask which one he had in his inventory.
So it gives you True Strike when it's on the person, I believe, correct? Or, yes.
Yes.
And obviously,
everyone who hits some crits,
passive
mini
critical
crits.
Strike with a mini crit, yes. So it's a nice item, but when we talk about Bloodthorn, I feel like we always use the word either expensive or underwhelming are the words that I hear thrown around with Bloodthorn a lot.
Yeah, it's usually, especially like in the usual manner where you end up seeing it, it's like a seventh item that you kind of see. Like somebody buys their whole item in their inventory and then they finish up with Bloodthorn, especially when there's not really anything specific that it's attaining to, because there's no one who has really evasion on the side of friends at all. Right. So it's a bit of a curious pickup there, but we'll see how it pays off for him.
I mean, it helps the Jugbright click, which is always a good thing. And I mean, if they do end up getting that Solar Crest or...
Yeah, that's exactly what I was about to ask. If the Dazzle or the Elder Titan were on their way or have a Solar Crest, maybe. Dazzle's very poor and Elder Titan only 4 stuff, so he's not really that rich either.
Oh, the supports, obviously. Dazzle is playing the... I would call it the 6th position, I'd guess. But...
Yeah. So what else does Bloodthorn do? It lowers the cooldown of your Orchid as well?
Yes.
So there's that. Also, the small benefit to it. I think it drops it a couple seconds, I think like 5 more seconds or so. Compared to an Orchid.
A bit more damage. Obviously, you get the crit for everybody. And
saving items a lot. I guess maybe he's... trying it out, feeling it out, not too sure. It's an interesting pickup. It's definitely different from what we're used to seeing, just the standard Daedalus.
There's so many items I can think of going in this game as an Ember Spirit that isn't Bloodthorn, but obviously, like you talked about, the supports, even you saw it against G, against the Darkseer, getting an Orchid off against him, I think he's very strong as well. So, you know, Orchid or Bloodthorn is not a bad item. It just felt like the Orchid itself might have been enough. But as you said in the last fight, I thought they needed more damage, kind of.
Yeah, it's just also weird because, like, you naturally build, like, Lotus Orbs and these type of items. And when you have Bloodthorn, it gets completely removed from this type of item. So, and Guardian Creeps as well, especially. But still, you know, it's like a player preference, and like he could be trying it out, and we'll just see how it pays off. We'll see how good it is in the fights.
Radiance
Hex now for Darkseer. Nice and early. Wow, yeah, finished that fast.
That is a well-timed Hex. His items right now are Mech, as well as Pipe, and Force, and Hex off the top of my head. That's what I think he's got. Aloha Dance. He's got a Daedalus, so...
Yeah, Guarding Greaves, Mech, or Guarding Greaves, Pipe, Force Staff, and a Gem.
And a hex. Gem. Yeah. With extra. He's rich. This Darkseer.
That definitely is another scary factor. I would imagine he gets the Blink Dagger next. There's no point in not. The Blink instant disable. They can even catch the Ember Spirit split pushing a lot. So it's Fnatic actually not farming as much that I would like to see them see. Friends is putting a lot of pressure on them, keeping them kind of trapped in their base. And they're farming more. And it's looking pretty good. They're keeping Fnatic pretty locked up in their base.
That Blink Dagger, I agree with you completely. I mean, we've seen so many instances of Wombo combos. Mushi, my friend, you might be a bit too far out here, and he's going to blink away just in time. 3-4-3 as well, being hunted down with that Gem Brosh. Putting on 2 illusions. Gush will come out, Sled of Fist, Searing Chains. No one really taking any of the damage from Fnatic as they've been able to get their way back inside the base somehow.
I think they saw the God Strength, though. Yeah, they're going to smoke up, and this is their opportunity to go.
They use BKB as well on Sven?
No, Sven still has BKB up, but he did. I mean, God Strength is the big one.
Yes. That's down for 60 seconds. Mid 1 will take care of mid with a Sleight of Fist, but here we go. All the ultimates ready to go, including Ravage coming out for that time.
Did he sell his Dominator? Aloha Dance? It's missing right now, so maybe it's on the Courier, or...
Dropped it or sold it. One of the two.
Okay, that's strange. He didn't really buy anything with it, the slot that he had open, but I guess he wanted to buy something? Oh well.
Well, as much as they wanted to try to find something out of this engagement, it's just not looking likely. Instead, they will settle for invading the enemy jungle, getting some farm. However, G and crew are close by. Friends is looking to perhaps initiate contest Roche. 3-4-3 might walk into a sentry if he's not careful, or the gem carrier.
3-4-3 has the dragon lance and he's going to be building into a basher next on the Ricky.
Like, that's the strangest item decision
it's
like
very bizarre.
I've ever seen. It's like
we've been seeing a lot more like the 4 staffs and stuff like this, like support type Ricky, but
No.
Even like the blink daggers so that you're like, get your cloud positioning.
I am totally down for four position Ricky turning into a semi carry.
Oh, me too. I mean, it's cool. I've never seen the Dragon Lance before. It's clever. It's interesting.
I personally like Diffusal Blade. And
yeah, of course.
I think that's the most common, but when you already have one, maybe that might not be the best idea. There is an MKB picked up for the Sven.
Okay, so that's what he
just
replaced the Dominator with.
There's a stun onto DJ. The smoke screen comes out, and G immediately pops the BKB. They're going to try to fight this. Stormhammer immediately dodged. DJ puts the guys by the little logo by Dance. Nicely done. You know, Shadow Wave for him, but they'll back up it so far. Radiance this time, last time it was God's attack. Strength. This time I think
it was just the BKB.
Okay, it wasn't Aloha Dance's BKB. And mid one, the split push continues. Although Aloha Dance and Shroom will head into the Roche Pit, and God's Strength is back up. So mid one will finish off that tower, and I think you could test here. I think you make a play, you have Ravage, obviously. So this is dangerous.
Sven's not gonna have God's Strength for the fight. And it doesn't have the Ravage comes out.
They will catch Aloha Dance, but now they're in the pit. Aloha Dance gets his low, and they bring him down. Dead for 86, tricks the train. Top as well, just to secure the kill as well, and that Dazzle is getting caught out. No fear forced to wait, making sure he gets at least a little bit further so he can complete that TP, and he's successful in doing so.
That was a very risky go to go for that Roshan.
I mean, I was like with Ravage and Ice Blast and mid one coming back with Slaughter Fist.
It just takes you too long, especially if it's just your Sven hitting it. Like that's your only Rosh hitter, and you're putting him in a weird position. If he gets hit by any stuns, he just can get bursted down very heavily. We saw it happen.
I know you like wow. you have the BKB, but it's hard when you just get jumped on by a Tidehunter. And he was even pretty far away, but still. Tier 3 towers being installed, and mid one jumping in looking for a Searing Chain. Won't find it. He doesn't have the Aegis and plus thrown at the ready if he needs it. Now Mushi picks the Scott B as well. The rest of the crew will finish off this tier 3 tower. We'll see if they back off or keep going right now. I'll smoke screen
Sven's not buying back. He doesn't have it. So, and they're definitely identifying that right now. So
yeah,
why not?
They're going in. There's going to be the Bloodthorn. Mid one is taking a bit of damage right now. Needs to be careful. Heck, stuff as well. And that's you in. Not to say they'll lose to the Aegis. Stop coming through. It's up in Ohio. No fear is low, but it's not dead yet. Still two dead at the center. Almost bringing out the TJ, and it will be the cost of the finale that does so. However, three dead. Everyone back alive with the exception of course DJ Mushi going on his TV. He is in trouble. They dropped the wall down. It's not going to do nearly enough damage. He's dead for 75 seconds. And 3-4-3 secures himself a double kill and perhaps the game fog with that last team fight.
Yeah, they get the racks. Everything was gained for them. Ricky just picked up a Bash River before that fight happened. He has 3,000 gold. Mid one, 7,000 to 400 gold after that Roshan in that top. Just the decision making from Friends there was very costly for them. Going for that Roshan is honestly like a game losing decision, but I guess they felt forced.
Something.
Yeah, felt pressured for sure.
I mean, Aloha Dance is having a great game until this point. Now the skill tree will come out. He has to be hit. He'll have to pop it. Got a strength not being used yet. He was stunned up by the Basher of all things, I believe, from the Ricky. And it looks like mid one's coming with a pick an arcane or double damage. Can't tell Omni slash God Strength. Here we go. And he should fall here. He's in trouble and will.
Wow.
Although he almost doesn't have damage to bring down mid one. No buyback for, of course, Aloha Dance. And that's the most important thing. They're going to chase Yokum again. Here's Vacuuman. But mid one is going to keep me. Silence up the Darkseer and bring him down. Mid one. We talked about it. He's so hit or miss on this hero. But when he's hitting, mid one is stellar on the Ember Spirit.
Rapier.
Go for it. Yeah, do it. Come on, mid one. Succumb to the peer pressure.
I mean, when he was on the couch, he was the one saying Rapier too.
Goes for like the most. Opposite choice in like Lincoln's Fear.
It's the right play. There's no point in him risking the game and going for Rapier. This is the like they finally are getting like their position on the game. They get the racks. They get the, all these huge opportunities. There's no point in risking it like that.
Yeah, I 100% agree with you.
We wanted it.
I mean, as fun as it would be to see a Rapier, Lincoln's Fear is going to help him win this game and not throw it drastically. This game is still up for grabs if they can even spend up the next 30, or if this bank can at least somehow. It doesn't have buyback, it's not even close, I don't think so. Really,
it's just gonna be too little too late.
Yeah,
at this point, so.
Maybe they can fight against the Mega, but they lose always one of block from the Bloodthorn and like 2 minutes from mid one. One of which might have been a crit, so the Ranger Axe will fall for it, which he's putting on the most pressure there with his items, including the Scotty that he just picked up as well. Good one with his new limited Lincoln Spear. They'll take down the mid set of racks, they'll head towards the bottom. And the top two net worth, Lucci and mid one. You'll often see them carry. And it looks like they're doing that again in this particular game.
Yeah. I mean, you just look at the grab. That's literally the Roshan. Right there where that decline begins, that's the Roshan.
Maybe
a little bit further ahead.
Yeah, right on there. Say, it's been one destroying tower. What is this?
Yeah, there you go. Right where the big decline begins. Cool. Yeah, so it's pretty much the decision making there from Friends. Really hurt them. A couple cocky plays from Aloha, but the game is still continuing.
And they're not done yet. They haven't lost Megas, and they certainly haven't lost the game. I mean, killing Bid 1, it might seem like an impossibility now, but later on down the road, it might be something that's doable as G is forced to pop his BKB against the Ember Spirit. Theoretically, could keep chasing, and might do. Yeah, G, unfortunately, literally half a second, maybe even less from TPing out. Gets caught with a Sleight of Fist Searing Chains combination.
Another 7k gold on mid one now.
God. Usually it's Bushi that likes to pull up the gold.
G's actually short of buyback, but he'll have it 62? In the next like 20 seconds
or
so.
Yeah, 20 seconds, roughly.
Like 35 seconds, whatever.
That's, I mean, he'll have it before the actual, like, he'll have it before he respawns, which is the most important thing. Oh, he did go for it.
Now, yeah, I mean now he has the Lincolns.
It's safer. He has the Lincolns here.
Now he has the Lincolns, and what else is he going to get?
Mid-1 seems like the type of guy that would pick up a Divine Rapier, honestly.
Uh-oh. We see some people having a little bit of a heart attack next to us. But
fanatic fans, like, can't tell if they're actually laughing or they're like, please don't die. Like, freaking out inside, certainly. Pressure up with the next pick up from the side of Ezra Loadin's forced to pop the BKB, but there is no follow-up. His blink just coming off cooldown right now. And he's gonna jump in, ravage from Ohana. He's got the refresh, he's trying to look for another, but doesn't even need it for Loadin's. In fact, they're taking it down three, including G. Aloha Dance, as well as always one of the fly, dead in the dirt. And no buyback for any of them. Unfortunately, G does have his, but he's up in 8 seconds. And right now, it looks like this may be very well the first game of this series going to Fnatic. As it's been some stellar play from really all the team, but mid one in particular, as well as 3-4-3. It's been pretty good.
Yeah, Fnatic definitely making some mistakes. Not the most crisp game coming out of them, but they definitely identified the strengths of their draft. They did a really good job of kiting Aloha Dance around. When he would pop his BKB, they would literally just like pretty much bail, leave one hero.